when we look at the challenges faced by these children with the lack of water and you know, lack of safe water, and also the lack of food, you can sort of split it into two things. The main risk with the water would be infection, which would cause diarrhea and potentially quite serious dehydration. The food aspect isn't quite so important, and they should be able to recover from that. If the reduction in oxygen is gradual, then actually the human body could adapt to that. If the oxygen levels are reducing, they'll get symptoms that are similar to altitude illness. So we get headaches, we get nausea, we get reduction in appetite. If you get a more rapid reduction in oxygen concentration, so you could go on to develop lung complications and brain complications as well. And then the other issue with the gases in there is carbon dioxide. It gradually builds up in the body. So that will make you, again, it will make you nauseous, it will make you flush, it will make you feel hot. And also it will make you start to feel drowsy and eventually would cause unconsciousness. The longer they're in there, the worse their bodies will become. So their muscles will be wasting, they'll be getting weaker over time. And the important thing there is to actually make sure they have the right nutrition. So they will need a good amount of protein and a good amount of carbohydrates. So really the usual balanced diet. Really, you want to be using the muscles as much as you can. But the downside of that is if you start using muscles and doing active exercise, that increases the amount of oxygen you need. The main issue of being in the dark is actually total lack of time perception. And also you tend to lose your normal body rhythms as well. So normal circadian rhythms are lost. And your body can't really cope with that. And then in terms of the eyes as well, interestingly over time, especially in pitch black, the eyes stop being able to respond to light. It makes the eyes incredibly sensitive when people leave any prolonged dark environment. However, that is reversible. So the physical problems are probably recoverable unless they get any severe injuries on the rescue attempt. And even those can be rehabilitated. But in terms of physical aspect, if they get out and when they get out, that should all be rebuildable with rehabilitation and good diet.